YouTube, happy new year, guys. It is January 1st, 2024, a brand new year, a fresh new start, guys. So today, in today's video, I have my 2024 ins and outs. So I have a list. Oops, hold on. Can I see? I have a list right here. And basically, I'm just going to follow my list. So I made a whole lot of ins. I made some outs. I have more ins than outs, which should probably be the other way around. I don't know. But yeah, let's get into the video. Okay, up first for my ins, saying no. Y'all, I'm a people pleaser. I like to make people happy. I try not to disappoint nobody. I need to start saying no. I always be like, yes, I'll do it. Sure. Like, and when I really don't want to do it, I'll say sure. But like, of course, I still do it because I didn't say no. But I really don't be wanting to do stuff. So I really need to start saying no. 2024, no, I'm sorry, I can't do it. I don't even got to say sorry. If I don't want to do it, I wouldn't do it. So my first one is saying no. I think I'm just going to go through the list, actually. I don't even think I'm going to break it up in parts because there's really no need to. My second one is cleaning my room every weekend. My room is cleaned right now. My bed will be made, but my sister is in my bed right now. Y'all can't see. Oh, there she is. Cleaning my room every weekend. I did clean my room last week, so it could be clean on New Year's, but she is. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Y'all, I threw a lot of stuff away, and I'm so happy because that stuff needed to go, like, actually. So cleaning my room every weekend because, you know, if you have a clean room, and every weekend, Monday or Sunday starts the week, you'll be good. Then you go to school that whole week and you come home to a clean room. So I'm gonna clean my room every weekend, so therefore my week could get started off. At least I have. So if I have a hard day at school, at least I come home to a clean room. My next one is doing laundry every weekend. I used to do my laundry every weekend, but then I started slacking. I had a hard month in October, November, so I stopped doing my laundry. I wasn't even wearing the same clothes. I was just not doing my laundry. And I was just wearing, like, more clothes in my closet. But that's not the point. The point is, I need to do my laundry every weekend. Because my laundry is literally just stacked up. And then, the last week, I just washed all them clothes. And I had to do 3 loads of clothes. Like, that's not good. I shouldn't have to do 1 at the end of every week. So, doing my laundry every weekend, I need to get back into that habit. The next one, doing something nice for myself every month. No matter if that's going to get my hair done, going to get my nails done, my feet done, my eyebrows waxed, my lashes done, doing a face mask for myself, buying myself some new skincare because I love going skincare shopping, y'all. Like, I love going skincare shopping, like, body, you know, smelling good, like, all that stuff. Like, I like that. So, I just need to do something nice for myself every month. I know I work, but I don't really work like that. I just filled out some job applications yesterday. So I'm trying to get a new job right now because they don't put me on a schedule. But my checks be so tight. So I be only getting what I need to get, and I don't get what I want to get. Like, if I need soap, like, I gotta get some soap. If I need some more deodorant, I have to get some more deodorant. If I need a toothbrush, I need a toothbrush. You know what I'm saying? Like, those are needs. Those are not wants. So I'm looking for a new job, but yes, I want to do something nice for myself every month because, you know, doing something nice for yourself, it just makes you feel better as a person, you know? So yes, learning a new skill every week as far as dance. I'm about to be a senior, y'all, in July. I'm gonna be a senior. I got college auditions coming up. I don't got no time to waste. So I want to learn a new skill every week. I'm gonna try. So this week, I think my focus is going to be on splits. I can do my right split, but my left split I can't do, my middle split I can't do. And even my right split, I'm not all the way to the floor, but I can pass for a split, but I need to be all the way to the floor, especially when trying out for college. You know, you got girls all over the world. You know, I'm going to HBCU, I live in Indiana, so there's no HBCUs here. So I'm going to go literally out of state to go to college with girls who live in that state, who know, like, who's in the dance world, who know how to do this stuff. Like, I don't know how, because I don't have the resources here of HBCU, because we don't have that here. So yes, learning a new skill every week is one of my goals. And it's just gonna make me feel better. Like, it's gonna make me feel like, okay, I'm doing something right. Like, I'm getting myself ready for college. Like, so this week I'm gonna practice my splits. Meditation and self-reflection of my week at the end of every week. I hold grudges. I do. I have a hard time letting stuff go. So I want to meditate and self-reflect. So the goal is it'll probably be Sundays, the days I clean my room, do my laundry. Actually, might be Saturday. Saturdays be busy. I don't know. But if not Saturday, then Sunday, after I clean my room, do my laundry, I want to self-meditate, self-reflect, let stuff go for that week. Of course, it can still be on my mind and it can still, you know, whatever. But I just at least want to talk about it to myself. Like, okay, what happened Sunday this week? What happened Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday? And what can we do to make next week better? Or what did you like about this? Or what could you have done better? You know? Or, you know, just trying to figure out the issue, the problem. Or if I had a good week, I like to do this. I want to do that more. I liked it when I did this. I liked it when she gave me that compliment. You know, just self-reflection, self-meditation, because I need it. Picking out my outfits for the week. Y'all, I was doing so good at the beginning of the school year. Like, I put my outfits together in a shared album with the shoes, the top, the pants, y'all. I did good. And it just made my life so much easier because I already knew what I was wearing Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. The weekends are so-so. Depending on what I'm doing that weekend, then that's going to determine my outfit. And I can just pick those out Friday or literally the day of because I have time. But during the week at school, I don't got no time, so I wouldn't be picking out my outfits. You know, that Sunday, put them all on a shared album for the week, boom, so I can just grab and go. And I also want to pick out my outfits the night before, so therefore if I already plan my outfits for the week, I can just take the outfit out of my closet, take it out of my drawer, lay it on the end of my bed, shoes are already out, boom. Period. And I be rushing in the morning anyway, so not having my outfits picked out, that be slowing me down. So just put my outfits on the bed, boom, I'm ready to go. Next is being more private. I need to be more private with my life. I don't know really what I want to be more private in my life, but I don't know. I'm still working on what that one means to me. I know what it means, like being more private, like, you know, not telling everybody your business, not doing all that, but I don't do that already. Like, I just tell, like, probably two people, like my two closest friends. One's a junior, one is a sophomore. She's a close friend of mine. I really just tell them my business, but I really don't do too. I'm gonna take that one off my list. I don't know. Another one is stop speaking negatively in the mornings. You know, when you get out of bed, you're just like, huh, I don't want to go to school. Huh, I don't want to get up. I don't want to do this. This is not the day. I don't want to go to school. I don't want to go to work. I didn't study for that final. Now I got to go take it. Huh, now my mood is a mess. And now I'm just irritated and bothered. Cut. No negative speaking. Of course, you're going to have your days. You know, that's life. You're human. We're all people. You know, it's going to happen. But I'm going to try to let it go. Because, you're lucky you woke up this morning, you know. So, I'm trying to get that out of my life. Bye-bye negative speaking in the morning. Get off my shoulders. Another one, making my bed every morning. Like I said, if I clean my room on Sunday, Saturday, Sunday, do my laundry Saturday, Sunday, self-meditate Saturday, Sunday, pick out my outfit Saturday, Sunday, on Monday, after I'm doing my little morning routine, make my bed, I'm out the door. And then when I come home, A made bed makes a difference when you come home. Because it's just like, oh, my room looks so cute. Like, a made bed makes a difference. So, seeing a made bed just instantly puts a smile on my face. Like, my room is clean. Like, that's the finishing touch. Like, you can't make your bed until you, like, literally all the way done with cleaning your room. Like, that's the finishing touch. Like, yes. Yeah, so, I want to make my bed every morning before I go to school. Or before I leave the house, but mainly before I go to school. Because school days should be the stressful days. The weekends, you chilling. You chilling on the weekends. I really don't care about the weekends, but school days, I want my bed made. Getting cute more and having fun. I get cute. I've been doing my big one here and there, you know. I do want to have more fun, though. I want to go out more. Not necessarily like to parties. Not that, but just like go bowling. Like I wouldn't do that every, well, I do that. No, I do that every month anyway. But I do like with my friends, you know, I want to like go bowling. Let's go to Dave and Buster's. Let's go painting. Let's go on a picnic. Let's go out to eat. Let's go to dinner, you know? So just going out more and just enjoying life, you know, having fun people around me that I care about and stuff. So yeah. Saving money. Oh my gosh, y'all, I am a spender. I be spending it like it ain't no tomorrow. Like, literally, my checks be having places to go before I get the money. Like, I get paid on Friday, check gone already. And mind you, I said I don't even get that much because my manager, she don't put me on a schedule no more. So I'm working 2-3 days at the week. So, baby, don't even got it to be spending. I just be spending like in a tomorrow. So I want to start saving, especially because prom is coming up and my birthday's coming up. My birthday literally be 2 weeks after prom. What am I finna do? And I'm in a car, so I gotta start saving my money. And for prom, you know, I'm doing my big one because it's prom. Y'all know I was the homecoming princess, so I have to do my big one for prom. I'm not running though, because we can't run. They said if you win homecoming princess or queen or whatever, you can't run for prom, which is good, because I wasn't running for prom no way. That's why I ran for homecoming, so I could see if I can win. And I won. Anyways, my crown up there, my sash, I'm keeping that for life. Yeah, so really just saving money, because I need to save some money. Don't stay in the situation for too long. That goes back to the meditating and the holding grudges and all that. So yeah, I kind of already touched bases on that topic. Drinking more water. I drink probably like 2 water bottles a day. That's not enough, baby. I need to drink some more. So I just want to start drinking more water so I can be more hydrated, especially because I'm a dancer. Well, I said on the days that I have practice, I do drink more water. But yeah, I just need to drink. Actually, I'll say 2.5 to 3 water bottles a day. And I think I'm supposed to be drinking like 6. So stay more hydrated. And I be like, when I dance, like I be getting out of breath and stuff. So I need to drink more water. And it's just good for my body, for health. I just need to drink more water, period. But my house, like, we ran out of water bottles so quick. Like, I'm just gonna have to start buying my own cases to just leave them in my room, so I can just have them for myself, because literally, like, we run through them so quick. So it's like the days, like, when I be wanting to get some more water, it's like I can't, or I have to drink faucet water. And I'm sorry, but I ain't drinking no faucet water if we got juice in the refrigerator. Like, no, like, I'm drinking some juice. If we don't got no juice, then I'll drink the faucet. But eating more fruits and vegetables. I just ate some strawberries today, but I just need to eat more fruits and vegetables. I do good at school. I eat fruits and vegetables at school. My favorite vegetable is carrots, so I really want to just buy some carrots and some ranch and just be snacking on that throughout the days. And my fruit, I just love fruit. I like watermelon, pineapple, strawberries, grapes, bananas. Like, I just love fruit. So fruit ain't an issue. I just need to buy some fruit. But vegetables, carrots are my favorite. Like, carrots is probably the only vegetable I can eat every day besides corn, but you have to make it and all that. So carrots is what I would say as far as the vegetables. So I want to start eating more fruits and vegetables because it's good for your body. You know, you're supposed to eat those anyway. So yes, studying and doing homework, y'all. I just really need to, because I always get my work done, but I always get it done at the last minute, so therefore I'm not really studying. I'm just rushing to do it. So I just need to start studying and doing my homework. Homework I do when I want to do it, or when it's due, like literally when it's due. So I need to start studying more and doing my homework. Yeah, especially on test days, like, I just need to, it's just something I need to do. I don't do it currently, or I wait last minute. That's not a good habit. So I need to start studying and doing my homework. Turning in assignments before the last day they're due. Again, that goes with studying, doing homework. I procrastinate a lot, and that's another one on my list too. Procrastination, stop procrastination. When I have so many days to do something, I'd be like, okay, I'm gonna just wait till this day to do it. And then it's like, oh no, I got this day, and I still got this many days left to do it, so I'm gonna just do it that day, and then I'm gonna do it that day, and then so then I don't do it literally till it's the final day. It's just like, oh my gosh. And then, like, when I self-reflect, I'd be like, I had this many days to do it. Like just last semester, I had 2 weeks to do a final, and I literally did not do it until the day it was due. Like, I literally didn't even start it until the day it was due. Luckily, I got a C+ on it. Whoop whoop. But we could have always went higher. We could have always got a B. We could have always got an A on it. You know what I'm saying? And if I would have put the extra amount of time and effort into it, I would have scored higher. So, yeah. Giving myself more grace. I'm very hard on myself. I push myself to the limit. I do. I'm a dance captain. I'm a choir captain. I'm the oldest daughter. I'm the only daughter on my dad's side. So, I'm the only child on my dad's side. So, I push myself to the limit. Have a younger sister that looks up to me. My team look up to me. My little cousins look up to me. You know, so, give myself more grace. I'm allowed to make mistakes, and I'm allowed not to be perfect. So, yeah, just giving myself my grace. Praying more, listening to gospel music and podcasts. I'm getting closer with God on my spiritual journey right now. I'm starting to pray more. So yeah, just like in the mornings, at night, whenever, just take about 5-10 minutes just to thank Him for another day, thank Him for all He does, to help my day, stuff like that. So yeah. Prioritizing myself more. That kind of goes into like doing something nice for myself. Like, you know, this is my world, you know. Not my world. This is my life. That's what I meant to say. This is my life. I'm not living it for nobody else. I'm living it for me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can always make people happy. You can always do what people want you to do, you know. So just prioritizing myself more. Doing what I want to do. Yeah. Accepting help. Y'all, I'm very independent. I really don't rely on nobody to really do nothing for me. Nothing that I can do myself anyway. So I really need to start accepting help. Like, can you help me? Not accepting it and asking for it. Can you help me? Or like, if it's too much on my plate, like, hey, can you do this for me, please? Or I need some more time on this, you know? I just need to start doing that because, like I said, I'm very independent. Always smell good scent wise. Y'all know, some days I just wash up and I be at the house. Baby, where's your lotion? Where's your perfume? No moisturizer? No nothing? Every time I step at the house, I need to have on a scent. So I'm starting moisturizer. But really, I really do put on perfume. I put on perfume. I don't do lotion, I don't moisturize all the time. So that's really what I need to do. My lotion. I do really good on school days. I don't do good on weekends. In some school days, I do. Some school days when I'm not showing on skin, I don't. Which y'all see right now, my hands are ashy right now. So just putting on lotion and spray when I step out. Going out with friends for dinner to catch up. Y'all know some of my friends I don't have classes with, because I know me in high school. So I only talk to them sometimes, some days. Which now I start going to dinner with my friends, you know? Hey girl, how you been? You know? Just to catch up with people and stuff. And yeah, now let's get into the outs of 2024. Okay. My outs of 2024 is overthinking. Y'all, I am a big time overthinker. Like, anything is just like, oh, what is this? What if that? What do you mean? What is this? What is this? Why? And I'm a why person, so like, I have to know why every single time. And I just want to let that go. Like, don't take it for nothing that it's not. If they didn't say it, they didn't mean it. You know, like, just take everything for what it is. Stop overthinking. Pushing myself to the limit. I kind of touched on this. I literally will push myself until I break. And that's a bad habit. Because it's just like, I can do it. But sometimes it's just like, it's not that you can't do it. It's just that you need rest. You need to be patient with yourself. So, yes, not pushing myself to the limit, but knowing my limits. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can do it, but let's try this tomorrow. Or I can do it, but let's try this next month when I don't have so much on my plate. You know? So, yes. Another out is giving more than receiving. That goes for friends, relationships, family, all that. I'm a giver. I like giving. I like making people happy. I like helping people. I'm done really. Cause the giver never receives as much as they give. So I'm kinda over it. I'm just done giving more than I receive. Like I just said about the overthinking. Just take everything for what it is. Not getting enough sleep. Girl, go to bed. I really be in a bed by like 9:30, but I just be on my phone. So then I'll be staying up. Or y'all know when you just be laying in bed, you just got that one question that just pop up in your head, and then it's like, oh, I gotta look on Google. Like, no, I need to stop doing that. Girl, go to bed. And getting enough sleep will also help you wake up, in a better mood. So yes, I need to get all 8 hours of my sleep. And if not 8, at least 6. So, yeah. Not eating dinner. Y'all, on practice days, especially if it's a hard practice, I don't eat dinner because I just be over it. I just come in my room and I just literally go to sleep. Especially if my mom didn't cook or nothing. And if I gotta fix myself some food, I'm not fixing it. So I'm just gonna go to sleep hungry. So I need to stop doing that because that also will make me hungry in the mornings, like hungrier than I should be, and then that could also make me in a bad mood because it's like I didn't eat, so now I'm hungry, and now I'm mad because I'm hungry, now I'm hangry, you know what I'm saying? So, hold on, girl, I'm gonna drop my iPad. Going to sleep with a heavy heart, I'm done doing that. Some days just be real bad days. Everybody got their bad days, everybody got their good days, everybody got their mid days. Going to sleep with a heavy heart, not even doing it no more. I'm gonna pray about it, I'm gonna meditate about it, I'm gonna journal about it, and that's just gonna be that. I'm gonna light candles, I'm gonna do all that I can do to make myself feel better. And if not, then I'm gonna go ahead and go to bed. But if I go to bed knowing that I did all that I can do to make myself feel better, that will make me feel better. And that will make me be better for myself, you know? So just going to sleep with a heavy heart, not doing it no more. Overspending, y'all. I already touched on that, but baby, no. I just gotta start telling myself no. You don't need that. You got that at home. You ain't out of that yet. You got something that looked like that. You already ate out 2 times this week. Don't do it again. You know, so overspending is out. Thinking about the past or the future too much. The past, it already happened. You can't go back to the past. The future is ahead of you. It's not even here yet. So I just be having to, I be having to chill. Just be having to chill sometimes because I'm very much like, my future, I just want it to be everything. Like, I want it to be everything. So I think about it a lot. I think about the past a lot. So I just need to think about the present, the future, the now. Saying I'll do it later, or the I'll do it later mindset. Girl, you ain't doing it later. Why are you lying to yourself? Girl, you're not doing it later. I'm done saying that because no, I won't. No, I won't. Or when I do it, I'm gonna be mad about it. Or I'm gonna only do it because I literally have to do it. And if I don't have to do it, I'm not doing it. So I'm just gonna do it right then and there. Okay, I'll do it now. That's what I'm gonna start saying. Self-doubt. I might doubt myself sometimes. Just happens. Then self-doubt, and I can do whatever I put my mind to. I have a whole lot of support on my team. My mom's a big supporter of me. My family's a big supporter. My friends big supporters. Coaches big supporters. So, you know, I can do whatever I put my mind to. Period. And I might sound corny, but it's true. Skipping my skincare routine, y'all. I'm really good with the morning skincare. I'm not good with the night. I skip it every night. I'm not good with it, so I have to get back on it. Actually, I'm going to do it after I do this video, my nighttime. Because it's January 1st. It's a new start. You got a new start, baby. You got a new start. Yes, I need to stop skipping it because... Why are you skipping it, girl? You want your skin, you want to have good skin, and you just keep skipping your skincare. Like, what is wrong with you? So, yes, I'm going to do that after I do this video. Worrying about what others think. I care. I ain't going to lie. Some people are like, I don't care about what people think about me. I care. I ain't even lying to you. I care. But, you know, I do what I want to at the end of the day. So, do I really care? But, no, I mean, people really don't say too much about me. I'm not in drama. I don't be in drama or anything like that, but yeah. I don't care. Perfectionism. I touched on this in another topic. I don't have to be perfect. So I can make mistakes. It's a part of life. You're not going to be perfect first time go around. It's okay. Popping pimples. Y'all need to stop. I really don't do it as much as I used to, but I still do it every now and then. I'm about to buy me some pimple patches. I don't know if they work, but I hope they do because I'm about to buy me some. So, yeah. And the last thing for my outs list is stressing about what I can't control, girl. You can't control everything. You can't control people. You can't control what people say. You can't control what people do. The only thing you can control is yourself, how you think about it, how you react, what you say, and what you do. You can't stress. Why stress? You ain't changing nothing. They don't care. They don't care about what they do, what they say. They don't care how it affects you. So you shouldn't care. You shouldn't stress. You shouldn't give two about it. Thank you guys for watching my 2024 ins and outs video. I hope you guys have a good New Year's, and here's to 2024. Bye.